You know, have you kind of been struck back by the success of it? Confidence issues, obviously that's a main part, the first part of the book. Would you, it's quite probably rare, would you find a player today who would have them same confidence issues, or do you think it's kind of a new generation now? Yeah, absolutely. And just taking things to your Birmingham days, I mean, you know, you describe it in kind of vivid detail. What was it like to kind of recall them memories when you were writing the book? Was it quite emotional looking back at that time?
Not really. It was quite... Although I remembered every minute of every incident of every day clearly, I wouldn't really say it was emotional. Cathartic, that's the word, isn't it, that we often like to use. Quite nice to write it down, and it was nice to share it with a load of strangers. So it was really funny because I remembered it ever so well. I never took any books. I remembered every incident clearly in my mind. So that shows what a profound effect it all had.
From an Everton perspective, first up in the book, there's a foreword by Phil Neville. You know, that must have meant a lot to you for Phil to write that.
Very, very much so. You know, the publisher said we could do a foreword by somebody, and they sort of said, well, ask David to do it. I said, not really, because I'm too close to David, and David's talked about a lot in the book as well, so it didn't make a lot of sense that. And then I thought, who's the most, I don't know, well-respected, renowned player of the current era at Everton? It had to be Phil, and I had a great relationship with Phil. But the funny thing was, Phil tied the whole thing in very well to the thread of the book, which we weren't really expecting. I wasn't expecting that. I thought he'd just say, oh, I'd like the book. But the way he wrote, it was quite personalised and it was quite moving, really. He almost sort of had an insight into that same thread. So it was really sort of profound, the whole experience, you know.
And kind of taking things back to the kind of chronological order of the book, you know, you had quite a diverse and interesting football career. You know, looking back, are you proud of what you achieved as a player and then into management? It was quite diverse, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so. You know, if you become a professional footballer, you've done pretty well in the first instance. If you can become a physio, again, it's not easy to get on a course to be a physio. If you become a physio, if you can work in the Premier League, yeah, I'm proud, but, you know, I'm grateful and proud. Not gloatingly proud and look at me, look what I did. No, I'm pleased and I'm proud, and I've been very fortunate to have met some good people along the way. So it's a nice feeling for sure, but not triumphalistic, obviously.
Yeah, and it shows a lot, doesn't it, how much the game's changed, because obviously the kind of money and what comes with the modern players today, and then back when you played, there wasn't perhaps that financial security, so. You know, you obviously looked for the second profession. I know that was something you were quite interested in early life as well. Do you find it quite amazing how that's changed in football?
Yes, I don't know if the players on their incredible wages are happier than I was at Halifax on £200 a week. But I can see they're not. Now, that's because I was really, really happy at Halifax.
Sorry?
Can I turn this call
Yeah, sure, mate. Yeah, sure.
Hello? It's okay. You got
that. Then that's alright, Mick, mate. Yeah, no worries, Mick, at all. Yeah, just staying on the subject, you know, David Moore, you know, you've worked, you know, in and around the team for, you know, numerous years. You must have great admiration for the job he's still doing, and, you know, what is he like as a character to still do, you know, he's one of the best managers, isn't he?
In my opinion, I don't know them all, obviously, so it's been a bit of a statement, but I couldn't speak more highly of him. Players. And the reason why the medical team was and is
highlight of your time at Everton, you know, one in your career as well, is the FA Cup final in 2009. You know, you've had several other occasions as well when you were at Everton that have been, you know, fantastic occasions. What was the FA Cup final like? You know, tell me about what the fans were like. You know, it was a great day, wasn't it?
Change of time. Well, do you want to come in? Like, because you've never come.
And if you're born to follow that club, you're lucky. I know at the moment it's like the sort of people who are in that, it's difficult in that, but you know, yeah, you might be following a club owned by somebody who you don't know where he lives, or somebody from America who has no real interest in the club, but a club that's just putting millions and millions and millions and millions of pounds